Hello, I'm Dr. Jonghyun Park from Seosan Duri Dental Office. So this is the first lecture on full mouth restoration. Today I'm going to talk about central relations, vertical dimensions, and occlusal plane, which are very important aesthetically and functionally. As you can see, you can have this kind of situation if you do not understand the topics of today. This is the case I'm ashamed of myself. In the early days of my clinical practice, I didn't understand properly the occlusal plane, so I did not give proper information to a lab. This is due to a dentist fault resulting in disastrous outcome like this. Fortunately, the patient didn't complain about aesthetics, so it has been used pretty well for the last 10 years. But whenever I see this case, I still suffer. If you come to master courses, even the cases that I want to hide will be given to you. First, centric relation. This case is the courtesy of my advisor, Professor Chan Jin Park. McLum et al. Used the chin point method using anterior jig to obtain centric relation to deprogram sensory reception function. And there are many other ways to obtain CR. Let's have a look at my case. The patient had for about 5 years, the pain in the left TMJ persistently, and the patient could hear the sand grinding sound. Even though the patient visited many hospitals, it didn't improve. First, when I obtained CR, to perform muscle deprogramming, I make the patient to bite on the cotton ball for 10 to 20 minutes. Depending on the presence of upper anterior teeth, various methods can be used to obtain CR. If you look at the model, as you saw in the previous video, it was at a position where reproducibility can be clearly achieved, but left to right asymmetry was severe. So I considered it CR-MIP discrepancy. A splint was used, which revealed the discrepancy of occlusion, and occlusal adjustment was made. Until the splint was used, the occlusion was okay to premolars or canines. But using the splint, the discrepancy in occlusion was revealed, so occlusion was adjusted. The opening increased quite a lot, and the pain was quite relieved in 5 years. The patient said various drugs didn't work, and she said at this time she felt like she was treated by God. The patient said immediately after rapid Invisalign orthodontic treatment, which was started 3 months before, left TMJ translation movement limitation occurred. Of course, the patient didn't use the expression translation movement. If you look at the patient carefully, you can notice the left deviation when mouth is opened. Due to the translation movement limitation on the left TMJ, a Lucia jig is similar as it separates the back teeth. To block the neuromuscular system, it is to find the position where anterior and lateral movement starts, which is considered CR. The lateral movement is impossible, so the movement is not registered. A CR splint is mounted. Splint mounting and continuous occlusal adjustments were performed. After 7 months, TMJ X-ray was taken. The left side is magnified. The left deviation is not completely resolved, but it is improved. The patient was relieved from acute pain. So in this case, the treatment effect was dramatic, as it was an acute case where the pain started 3 months before with ortho treatment, a chronic problem would be more difficult to resolve, but acute pain like this seems easier to resolve. Using Lucia jig, I'll show you how it works. This is how to record lateral and anterior movements. CR is considered the starting point of such movements. In the posterior region, intrajaw relation is taken using a silicone bite. If you come to master courses, various CR obtainment methods will be taught with hands-on. I talked about CR and we don't have a lot of time today. I believe you learned CR, MI, or CO in dental school, but there are some confusion in understanding them. If you come to the master course, those will be explained in detail. For full mouth rehabilitation, I use Lucia jig quite actively. Next, vertical dimension. Regarding the vertical dimension, I believe you are more familiar with this than CR. It means the superior-inferior relationship of the maxilla and the mandible when the teeth are occluded in maximum. VD can be decreased due to tooth wear from congenital tooth abnormalities, habitual parafunction, tooth wear, loss of posterior support, wear due to restorative material. The loss of vertical dimension is based on pronunciation, physiologic rest position, facial soft tissue morphology support, bioesthetics, loss of posterior support, and history of wear. Dawson, in his famous occlusion book, said that the vertical dimension decrease due to tooth wear is compensated by the alveolar bone extrusion. So the vertical dimension doesn't change throughout the lifetime. I believe this is true when a patient has very healthy alveolar bone, hardly any prosthesis and no fracture on the occlusal plane. You just need to understand this classification table. This is the take-home message. After the lecture, please review this. Classification of VD and methods of restoration. When restoration space is insufficient, as in category 1 or 3, VD increase is necessary for restoration, even when there is no VD loss. But if there is insufficient restoration space in category 3, VD increase is necessary. I'll keep talking about what that means using cases, but it is best to minimize the increase. Dawson objected VD increase. When do we need to do it? I will refer to Professor Yang Jin Lee's book, It is True as I Heard It. When incisors are worn and there is loss of posterior teeth, we need to increase VD for sure. It would be impossible to do restoration without increasing the vertical dimension. When there is support for the posterior teeth, periodontally unstable, we need to consider increasing VD in case of lack of restorative space. Dawson would understand this. No vertical dimension loss throughout a lifetime. Do you understand this case? But it happens when periodontal disease is there and there's a loss of a posterior teeth. It is impossible to restore without increasing VD. This is a difficult case. Incisors wear, posterior teeth are restorations. If re-restoration is performed, VD must be re-evaluated. As another dentist that could have restored the posterior region when the VD was low. In this case, as I said before, we need to consider whether VD is really lost or compensation for VD is necessary. We need to consider increasing VD if occlusal fracture is present. Here, the speed attrition cannot catch up with the speed of extrusion. So if there is occlusal fracture, we need to think a bit differently. If there is only wear without fracture of the occlusal surface, VD increase should be carefully considered. If there is only wear without occlusal plane fracture, There is no obvious reason to increase the VD, and there is an insufficient space. You can just provide a posterior stop like this, gold crowns at number 36 and 37. Let's compare these two cases. On the left, the attrition compensating eruption due to opposing ceramic raises gingival line, and it's not VD loss. But for the right-hand side, if there is wear without change in the gingival line height, increasing VD should be considered. If gingival line height remains constant and attrition occurs, in most cases, space for restoration is insufficient. Even without clear VD loss, VD needs to be increased for restorations. If you look at this case, some options are available. If only the restorative space permits, it's good not to increase VD. If the patient just wants to have chewing function without increasing VD, implant restoration can be a good clinical option. But if a patient wants aesthetic improvement, a minimal VD increase needs to be performed. So with the minimal VD increase, the patient obtained aesthetic outcome. When VD is low, what problem would it present? When we were in a dental school, we learned and took exam on this topic quite a lot. The problems include angulocolitis, dissonance of facial expressions, and depth. Let's look at this case. Before prosthetic restoration, there was a huge freeway space discrepancy of 5 millimeters. Angulocolitis is observed. So in such patient, there is a high probability that VD is low. Because of it, saliva can be retained and the fungus can grow. And restoring the vertical dimension would take a lot of time. Fortunately, the patient's angular colitis improved very much. If you look at here, VD is lost. The case is by courtesy of Professor Chan Jin Park. Dissonance of facial expressions is observed. With the recovery of VD, facial expressions will improve. It means VD is directly linked to aesthetics. This case is the courtesy of Professor Ye Jin Lee of Gangneung Wonju University Prosthodontics Department. With the VD loss and insufficient space for restorations, it looks very challenging with aesthetic requirement as well. Generalized alveolar bone loss and crown fractures. Provisional restoration was used to evaluate the patient's adaptation to the increased VD and satisfaction with the function. Definitive prosthesis was completed aesthetically and functionally. Compared to the initial photo, a lot of improvements have been made. In this case, it is not possible to restore without raising VD. Let's review what we learned in dental school. I determined VD by referring to physiologic rest position. Additionally, swallowing or speech can be considered. I make a patient sit upright and completely relax so that upper and lower occlusal plane distance is 2 to 4 millimeters at the premolar area. 2 to 4 millimeters, a frequent exam question in dental school. It's hard to access premolar area, so alternatively, I measured from the tip of the nose and tip of the chin. VD is 2 to 4 millimeters smaller at physiologic rest position. VD is lost due to the loss of posterior teeth. What do you think? There's a lot of bones, so implants can be placed. But if we have to recover the lost VD, the case is always challenging. wax was roughly softened and the wax frame was fabricated in the treatment room. For physiologic rest position, the rim was adjusted to be within 2 to 3 millimeter range. Alu wax was used for further adjustment. Interjaw relation was obtained after 3 millimeter reduction in physiologic rest position. Temporary restoration was completed. The final restoration was completed. You will be able to learn accurately how to find the VD at the physiologic rest position in the master course through hands-on. Next, occlusal plane. We learned this in dental school. The direction of masticatory muscle movements is to facilitate putting food on the occlusal table. Wilson's curve needs to be provided. We don't need to explain this curve of speed. And the Camper's line is very important for aesthetics. This is the Camper's line. Occlusal plane was not properly considered here. In this case, further reduction of occlusal plane at 24 and 25 should have been made. Summary. In the past, I thought face bow was not necessary right after I finished my residency. However, to deliver better information of patients to a lab, face bow is very helpful for more aesthetic and functional prosthetics. Of course, we can use articulation paper, photos, and the provisional replication, but the more information we provide to a lab, the better the outcome. We need to provide maximal patient information to a lab to obtain more complete in terms of aesthetics and functions prosthesis. This case is by courtesy of Professor Yoon-hyuk-ho of Gangneung Wonju University. In this lecture, I talked about centric relation, VD, and occlusal plane. In complete edentulous patient, we created something out of nothing. I hope this has been helpful for you to achieve a better outcome. Thank you for your attention.